Jesse! Vinny.
Summer. Hello, everybody. Thanks for joining me again. Hang on. Technical difficulty. The fan is humping the mic stand, and therefore you get a buzz. Yeah. So Here we go. 4th of July is over with. I hope you guys had a great 4th of July. We didn't do too much. We actually didn't see any fireworks except the neighbors shooting stuff off in the neighborhood. We saw fireworks last weekend at some event they had at one of the big parks here, and they were really fantastic fireworks. I think the city's broke now. This is not a big city around here. So we didn't really need to see them. We want some crazy stuff on Netflix. We finished Stranger Things, season 4. And it's like a big thing now, man. And season 3, one of the guys, I forgot which name, which guy was that, Mike? I think it was. I'm probably wrong. He was wearing a Dio denim jacket. It's like really good advertisement. If I was somebody, I would have made those and marketed them on the Dio website. But who am I to say what to do? And that shirt was, the jacket was made from the shirt from Ronnie's auction that Wendy Dio did. So it's an official part of Ronnie's collection. That shirt. I don't know if he wore it or what he did with it. But so that was like really cool, you know, very cool advertisement. Too bad they didn't play a song, you know. You know that song that goes. I can't play it on here. They cut me off. That's why I play all these obscure things and repeats. What the hell? You listen to radio, you hear repeats. So that was cool. And what else is going on? We got Ronnie's birthday coming up. And I'm going to play a couple of little snippets from Holy Diver. Some little things you may not know or you may know. I might have mentioned a few of them before on this show. But I'll play a couple snippets as well. And what else? We went to, the funny thing was, over the weekend, we went to the mall, right? And do you ever have pretzels. What's a pretzels? Yeah, I like those once in a while. They're a little bit on the carbohydrate side, but I said, let's go get a Wetzel's pretzel because it was early and we were hungry. So we go up to the guy and can I get a salted pretzel? The guy goes, we don't have any pretzels. Young kid. I started laughing. I went, what? Are you kidding? That's something I would do if I worked there. Somebody come in and go, can I get a pretzel? I go, I'm sorry, we're all out of pretzels. But he was serious. I went, you got to be kidding. Is this the salted pretzel? No, we don't have any pretzel. I said, this is Wetzel pretzels, isn't it? He said, yeah, but we don't have any. She's making them. It's going to be 15 minutes. But that's your biggest seller. How come you don't have them, you know? So it was better anyway. I didn't need to eat a pretzel, you know? Remember, slow and steady and even. Listen how even this is. That's what I always say and teach. You gotta go slow first. That's just left, right, foot. Right? Pretty easy. And then you get a little faster. But you gotta keep it steady. You don't want it like this. That's no good. Can't dance to that. Nice and even. That's where you practice anything, you know, anything you want to play, even a beat, you know, steady. Simple beat like that sounds professional because it's nice and steady. It's locked in. A little bit of hi-hat. A little bit of ghost notes. and it's nice and steady because I'm always hearing like there's a metronome, but there is no metronome. It's in my head. That's why I can go, you know, with these open fills. Rush when there's a big hole in there. You gotta stay in the pocket. So I always hear that. I used to listen to the metronome a lot. And back in the day in the 80s, Holy Diver, all those albums, the Mob Rules, we didn't use a metronome. I was the metronome, I guess. And, you know, songs tend to speed up a little bit toward the end. But that's natural, you know, let the song breathe and wasn't so stiff, you know. I mean, I play with a click all the time, so I do a lot of sessions, you know. But I don't even listen to the click. The only time I hear the click is if I'm off a little bit, you know. Sometimes I'm on and the click's off. No, I'm kidding. But you don't always have to play exactly with the click. You don't have to stay. If you're doing something like that, you know, I'm scared to move. Because the click's going. Just make sure you're on, you know, and that click's in there. Like the click is like the cowbell. More cowbell, right? Good idea to listen to cowbell, all you guys out there that want to learn how to play a little better and a little bit more pro and heavy and stuff. And then I always say you got to make the face, you know, like these licks. Like you don't want to do it smiling like. It's better like. Like you mean it. So that's a couple of things there. What else is going on? It's Michael Sweet's birthday today or yesterday or tomorrow. Now I'm going to blank. You know the band Yellow and Black, the religious band. But I know Michael Sweet is great. I can't think of – I'm having a senior moment, sorry. I know the band, but him. Happy birthday, Michael. You're watching. I doubt if you're watching. Everybody's at the airport because they're getting stuck because the planes don't fly the way they used to. I mean, I keep reading in the news, and Lala's reading the news going, and these guys got stuck, and John Moyer's stuck at the airport. I'm like, oh, shit. Oops, sorry. Crap. And a couple other bands, you know. One band with Korn missed a show in Spain or just made it or something. And who's the other one? The one band... Wait a minute. Striper. Lala says Striper. That's it. But who's the band that had to go buy clothes?
Oh, was it
Jane's Addiction.
Jane's Addiction. They lost all their luggage.
They lost all their luggage. And did they make the show?
They made the show.
They made the show with no clothes. So, I don't mean to laugh at them, but it's pathetic what's going on with the airlines. You know, and they're charging so much money for tickets now. It's stupid. And they had to go to the store and go buy some clothes. Maybe they went to Target. I don't know if they have Target in Sweden. And I did that once where they lost my luggage and I had to go buy something. I think I bought some tight sweatpants. You know, I think it's, I don't know. I forgot what it was. I was doing a drum clinic tour and they lost my luggage. Ever since then, you know, when I travel, I bring on a carry-on bag, put it up above. And in there is some sticks, drum key. I don't need a pedal anymore. I used to be paranoid and always bring a pedal, you know, my pedal, which is configured the way I like it. It's very tight and fast. Now I can make mostly any pedal pretty close to that, you know. And so I don't do that. I bring sticks, keys, and then I bring definitely something to play in, a couple of shirts, black shirts. headbands and earplugs and then some clothes, hair dryer. And sometimes I bring this fan. Check it out. This can't check it out. It's stuck. Yeah. This fan's small. I got it a long time ago. It's a small fan. So when I go out and do, I used to do a lot of drum clinics, I would bring that in the carry-on as well. You know, because sometimes I go, I need a fan. And I get to the venue and there's this big attic house fan, this thing this big, you know. I've got your fan. They thought bigger was better. And the fan, you know, it's too much. You see, I like to adjust this fan as I play live when I get warmed up. I put the fan, you know, on me more direct. And then sometimes that's a little much because now I'm cooled off, so I'll turn it away. So I play with the fan. And I also do the hi-hat live, too. I'll move the hi-hat. Certain songs, I'll move it a little bit closer. And I've had some guys tape it down, and then they go, oh, shit. I'm trying to move it, and it's taped down, and I can't move it, you know. So anyway, Lala's here, and she's walking over some wires to get to the microphone. Hi, Lala.
Hi.
I need to see that thing on the screen on the right side, so you turn the chair a little bit. That's it.
Don't want to hit any of these. All these.
Yeah, I know. It's like a booby trap in here. Okay, so Holy Diver, right? It went double platinum. It's going to be Ronnie's 80th birthday on the 10th. And on the 8th, the new remastered, remixed Holy Diver version is going to be released. I don't have it. I can't tell you what it sounds like. Probably be the last to get it. But I heard there's some outtakes that they found and put it on there too. And I know Holy Diver ended, I heard the end of Holy Diver, usually it ends with a fade out, but it went to this 2001 ending that we always play around with, just goofing off. You know, we play until we get to the end of the song, then we play whatever. I might go double time, we'll do some crazy stuff. And we always did that with Dio and Sabbath, not so much. Because it was Sabbath. But that's on there. The end goes dan da 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 dang ding dum boom 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 boom. And that was a goof ending. That was just for us, but it's on there too. So you guys could check it out. You get all these things you're not supposed to hear, outtakes and all that stuff. So let's take a couple of questions.
Woohoo.
We got to be quick. We're running late for once.
Oh, all righty.
Okay.
Do you prefer heavy sticks or lighter sticks? And is there a difference when you play?
Yeah. These are 5B pretty much. They're Chromacast sticks. But I play with the butt end, you know? When I hit the rim, there's a lot of beef going to the rim, you know? Because I'm hitting with a butt end, and there's a lot more wood down here. You might not hear that much of a difference, but I can feel the difference. Usually I go like this. Okay, now I'm going to play with the tip. Now I'm going to play with the butt end. Tip. No, I'm kidding. But that's the way I play. So 5B, they're pretty much the average standard rock stick. The other night I jammed, what did I jam with? Oh, I got up at this club I told you a couple of weeks back, Marco Minimum, and we were jamming. And he had some thin pencil sticks. And it was like, oh, man, I can't play with these things. It's definitely a different feel. So mess around with your sticks. Get something that you're comfortable with. Okay, next question.
Do you recall the type of sound effects that were used for the non-vocal tract E15? 5150 on Mob Rules.
I don't know. That's a whole bunch of stuff. Geezer named it, of course, and I think a lot of it. I don't know who played the keyboards. Maybe Jeff Nichols, and then Geezer overdubbed bass with a wah-wah on it and some effects. I don't know what the effects were and stuff, but it's very Geezer Butler, you know, very out there and dark sounding. Great intro. Okay, let's take one more question because you know what? We're going for Mexican food. Taco Tuesday.
Woohoo!
Why not eat more?
Yes. Oh, my gosh. Too much weight. Do you use a standard skateboard washer? And how tight do you use it?
What's that?
The standard skateboard washer. And the
The skateboard washer. Yeah, I told you guys that I used to use a skateboard washer. I'd still have them as they're in the toolbox in the garage over here on the top of the hi-hat. This one's a hard rubber one. This is from a different company. The skateboard washer was a skateboard washer that I cut in half. My tech did that, and it lasted. It's still good. You could use it for another 30 years. It's crazy. And I've used it since Sabbath, 40 years, and still good. This is hard rubber, and this one will last a long, 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 long time. So I like the hi-hat to be tight. I don't like it to move so much like this, back and forth. So. So it's nice and tight. It allows me to be fast. A lot of times, I need the hi-hat as a timekeeper, like when I'm doing these kind of routines. I'm just going like this. It's keeping me in time. These are on the ends. It's like a double bass drum thing with single. I'm just going left, right, single. Bass drums with the right hand, hi-hats with the left. Hi-hat being tight like that with that washer, it's very clean, and I can hear it like that. And if it's loose, hard to do some of this stuff. So, and these are 14-inch hi-hats. And these are also Sawtooth. It's the drum company that makes this and puts the show on. Thank you, Sawtooth and Joe Fuco. And these are the Hickory kit. This is the high-end kit, 6 plies of Hickory. Solid steel lugs, 3 millimeter hoops. No filler in this drum. These drums sound great. I love the sound of these drums. So we just started using them this year. We got them. And check it out. And everything on Chromacast app is 40% off. I think all the drums, accessories, everything Sawtooth. Okay? So these sticks are Chromacast, so I don't think the sticks are 40 off. But these drums are 40% off now. You can check it out online. I would, and it was the sale they had 2 weekends ago was 50% off because they're overstocked. So check it out on the app, godpsmusic.com, and go to Sawtooth, and there's something floating around on this website here while we're doing the show, where you can click on and get 40% off, you know. So check it out. They got tons of stuff, you know. Everything's up there. They make guitars, basses, everything, and cowbells, you know. And you can get more cowbell for 40% off. But I don't think they make the cowbell. So anyway, I want to thank you guys for joining me, and hello to all my friends, and AC, Heidi, and Steven. And
Charlie's on.
God bless you, Charlie. And who else?
Angelo.
Angelo Acuri is the original engineer of Holy Diver. Got those amazing sounds on the first 4 records. I don't even know how many records. You lose track. And Angelo's an amazing person, and my brother, I love you. And who else is on?
Heidi.
Jace. So fast. Jace, young drummer. He plays so fast, he had to name himself twice. It's like, wow. And Angie, his sister. Very good artist, too, by the way. So anyway, I'll see you guys next week. And thanks for tuning in. and I'll have another fun-packed episode of me. All right, thank you, guys.
One more thing. Trunk will probably have a live event going on there.
What's that?
Eddie Trunk at the Rainbow.
Yeah.
Somebody was asking, will it be streamed? And I know
I don't know. Probably some of it will be. Trunk's hosting the Rainbow thing on Thursday night.
Yeah, I think it's on his show, or he'll put something on there later.
Yeah. So I would imagine some of it will be streamed.
Yeah.
And
Check with Eddie Trunk.
Check with Eddie Trunk's site.
Social media.
Eddie. Okay, so I'll see you guys next week.